My name's Pat Gelsinger. I'm the CEO of Intel, and I've had a long and wonderful history with AWS. First in my EMC role, then as CEO of VMware, and now as the CEO of Intel. A great partnership over many years. Well, I recall 15 years ago when I first saw the cloud and S3 and EC2 emerging, and my first reaction was, huh? Right? Why do I run it in the cloud versus in the data center? And all of a sudden the light bulb went on and I said, this will change the industry. This will change how people use computing. And wow, that's certainly been the case over the last 15 years. Intel and AWS, EC2 have had an incredible journey together, where AWS is always saying, how can we do a bigger module, a bigger node instance type? So these in particular have been areas that Intel and AWS have been able to innovate together in exciting, powerful ways. And more recently, as we've talked about, our Intel Foundry services and AWS is one of our first customers for those. So we're quite excited that this partnership will keep nudging both of us along to do greater and greater things. Well, the first time I saw some of the discussions around AI and SageMaker, it was sort of like, wow, making AI truly accessible for developers in a very easy to use and powerful way. And of course, how we could enhance silicon underneath that to make it faster, to make it more programmable, to be able to solve some of the data type and data size problems associated with AI. And all of those uniquely being made available with AWS and Intel working together. Cloud is becoming this ubiquitous infrastructure. But all of a sudden, as we start to see 5G and edge computing, it's how does the cloud go from being a place, which it largely is today, but a computing model that truly is available wherever the customers will want to use it. I believe this next phase of cloud isn't just about how we make it bigger and faster, but it's how we make it truly geographically dispersed, where cloud goes from being a place to truly a computing model accessible to all.